Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. If you have just unboxed your shiny new Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 7, you are in the right place. In this video, I will walk you through the first time setup step by step, perfect for beginners. Let's get started. First thing first, let us power on your phone. Press and hold the power button, it is also your fingerprint sensor. Located on the right side, just below the volume keys. As soon as you see the Samsung logo, you can release it. Give it a few seconds to boot up and you will be greeted by the welcome screen. Now you can complete this setup using either the outer display or the larger inner screen. For this guide, I will use the inner large display for a better view. Go ahead and choose your language. Then tap Start. Next up, you will see the end user license agreement and privacy policy. These are mandatory, so make sure to select them. Sending off diagnostic data is optional. I usually uncheck this to keep things simple. Once you have made your choices, tap Agree. You will then see Easy Setup with another device. This is great if you are transferring data from an old Android or iPhone. For now, we will skip this and tap Setup Manually. Time to get connected. The Z Fold 7 supports both 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz bands. Select your network, enter the password, or use a QR code if you have one. Your phone will take a moment to get ready. Connect to a mobile network. If you wish to configure eSIM or insert physical SIM card, you can do it now. For now, let me choose Setup Later in Settings. You will then see Copy Apps and Data. This is where you can transfer everything like apps, photos, contacts, and even your Google account. If you want to do this, tap Next and follow the prompts. For this video, I will skip this step. Now, you will be prompted to log into a Google account. While you can skip this for now, I highly recommend signing in later. It is crucial for downloading the apps from the Play Store and using all of Google Sync features. I will skip it for now, but remember to come back to this. Next, the phone will ask you to protect your phone with the options like face recognition, fingerprint, PIN, pattern, or password. For this setup, I will skip this for now and confirm with Skip Anyway. You can always add security later. Then you will see Google Services. Review these options and unselect anything you don't want. Once you are happy, tap Accept. Choose your preferred search engine. I will pick Google and tap Next. Your phone will take another moment to prepare. You will now have the option to add a Samsung account. You can sign in, create a new one, or retrieve details. To skip, tap Forgot password or don't have an account. Then set up later in settings. You can always do this later if you prefer. Just tap skip if you are not signing in now. Next, review the Samsung service legal information. At a minimum, select terms and conditions to use Samsung customization services. You can skip this entirely if you wish to do it later. Then, for Samsung service, you can opt out or keep the options based on your preference. Tap Agree to proceed. Time to choose your display mode, light or dark. I will stick with light and tap Next. Finally, you will see getting recommended apps like Smart Tutor app. You can keep or unselect these. Make your choices and tap Next. Taking care of your phone. Very important information to safeguard your phone. Please read this carefully. Tap Next. Almost there. You will see the message, you're all set up. Tap Home. And there you have it. You are now on your home screen. If you pull down the notification area, you will see any steps you have skipped during the setup. You can go back and complete these whenever you are ready. Your phone will also continue updating and installing the apps in the background. So, don't be surprised if you see some activity. That's how easy it is to do a first-time setup of your new Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 7. I hope this guide was helpful for all you beginners out there. If you found this video informative, please hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more helpful tech guides. Thanks for watching.